Extract from the 501st Official Contact Conversation of Wednesday, the 1st of September, 2010, 2:00 p.m. Billy says, it was asked, why wasn't it discovered earlier, that Isa Rashid had used old, traditional Christian terms in the translation of the scrolls, whereby things weren't represented correctly. Also, it did, indeed, result that he also omitted important things because these didn't fit into his lay priest concept. From my side, I didn't know all this at that time, when I prepared that Talmud Emmanuel, for publication, and I also had no information from your or Arahat Athasatha's side. Patar says that's right. Of course, we already knew from the outset about the fallibility with regard to the translations and about certain important omissions. Unfortunately, despite his aversion to the erroneous Christian teachings, he was imprisoned in his faith resulting from it, for this was deeply rooted within him, as it is with all religious believers. Consequently, he couldn't free himself from it completely, as this is the rule for all religious believers. But concerning his translation errors and omission errors, it is to be said that we deliberately let the whole thing run in the already executed manner because there would have been too much turmoil at that time and your life would have been endangered even more than what would have happened if you had published the entire actual translation of the scroll. Through a possibility forecast, we fathomed that you wouldn't have overcome everything but rather would have lost your life if you had spread the whole comprehensiveness of the scroll at that time. Thus, we said nothing about this and waited until the aggressiveness had smoothed itself, which has now been the case for quite some time. It really was enough already that in the course of the years after the publication of the Talmud Emmanuel, assassination attempts were perpetrated against you and that you always only very barely escaped all 22 attacks. But now, since the first malicious waves have smoothed themselves, which were raised because of the distribution of the book in certain circles, the time has become ripe to work on the correct translation and to disseminate it. Of course, this will also cause unpleasant reactions in certain religious circles and among believers enslaved to faith in God as well as among all your adversaries, but according to our judgment, this can no longer become a great danger for you. Billy says of that which you speak, with regard to your possibility forecast, of this, you have never said anything to me. Indeed, I knew that Isa Rashid wasn't able to free himself completely from his faith in God and Jesus, as I have also found out that old, traditional Christian terms were used in the translation of Isa Rashid, but I didn't know why you didn't say anything about this. Due to the silence of you all, I assumed that everything, indeed, had its correctness and that everything corresponded to the contents of the scroll. Patar says that we didn't speak with you about this. Our further reason for this lies in the fact that you wouldn't have been in agreement with the publication of the defectiveness of the translation. Consequently, you would have insisted on writing and publishing the whole thing very exactly and correctly. But this, as I already said, you wouldn't have survived, as our possibility forecast had yielded. You would have been insidiously murdered through one of the assassination attempts, of which there would have been even more. Noting this in the newly revised and edited Talmud Emmanuel would certainly be appropriate and useful. Billy says you may, indeed, be right about that, for I probably would have actually rebelled. And making the whole thing clear in an introduction in the Talmud Emmanuel is, indeed, a good idea and necessary. Patar says we knew that you wouldn't have been in agreement with the old publication, which is why we didn't mention the defectiveness, as I already said. We also took our possibility forecast into consideration, whereby we realized that you would have been a